So, a relation.
Yo, I don't have any.
Definition. A relation is just any set of x and y coordinates. So it's a very vague term. And there's probably a real good definition in a math textbook somewhere, but this is my definition. You're going to like it. Any set of x and y values. So it could be a table, a graph, a function. But it's just very general, any set of x and y values. That there's a relationship between the x and the y. Very simple. Now, a function, however, is more specific. A function is a relation such that each x value has exactly one y value. Every x value corresponds to one and only one y value. They're monogamous. Yeah?
That doesn't work. I'm sorry.
There can be only one. And let's think about what this means. And you could also say, if you want to get fancy, you could say that each value in the domain, remember I said coming attractions, so we're going to start talking about domain and range. But I said, remember the input x value, domain, output y value, function value, range. Yeah? Okay. So you can say that a relation such that each value in the domain corresponds to exactly one value in the range. Okay, so remember our little vending machine example?
Sure.
So let's say our input, which is our domain, is here, and then our output, which is our range, is here. Now, so our vending machine, you can press the little buttons and you can type in A1 and you get the Skittles. A2 and you get the Snickers.
All the lighter than Coke.
Snickers!
Wait, you press any button?
And A3 you get
Lay's
potato chips.
I was going to say Twix.
And then you can type in B1.
Dog kibbles.
You get what?
Dog kibbles.
You get dog kibbles, for sure. That one stays stocked.
Oh, dude, it's delicious.
Mmm. I smell bacon. And then if you press B2.
You get Cadbury eggs.
You get what?
Cadbury eggs.
Mmm, I know that's right. Cadbury. I'm spelling it how I spell it. I don't know. And then one more, B3.
It's Cadbury eggs.
Cadbury eggs. The little chocolate egg filled with caramel and
caramel.
Whale blubber.
It's
sugar coated lard.
I know, it's
better have caramel.
M&M's.
No.
Wait, M&M's a rapper.
He pops right out. Okay, like, so this is. This is a vending machine that kind of represents a function. There's one input, and it corresponds to exactly one output. Now, imagine if you had this other vending machine over here.
It's just like Russian roulette.
Except it's not.
You're not going to kill yourself. I mean, you are.
Now, this one, you press A1, and you get out.
Stay soft.
Stay soft.
Good one.
You get out.
I'm gonna write all this stuff again. Why? Snicker. I don't feel like writing all that stuff again.
Just do it as
how I feel.
I'm just gonna do it here. So let's.
I don't feel like writing that again.
You can't make me. Right? So let's imagine we have a new vending machine down the road, And I go up to it and I press A1 and I get the Skittles and I go, nom nom nom, I love Skittles. And then Alexa says, word, I'm trying to get those. She goes up, puts in the money, presses A1, presses the same thing I pressed. But she gets the Snickers.
No, word, trying to get them.
Let me hold them. But she presses the same input and she gets the Snickers.
What?
And she's like, I can't even eat these. I'm allergic to peanuts. It's going to kill me. And she'd be mad, and she'd be shaking the vending machine, and she would say, this thing is not functioning properly. Hey! So it's not a function. So, or if I press A3, and I get kibbles, or Lay's, or Cadbury eggs, right? This would not function properly. This is not a function. So this is an example where each x value has multiple y values, and you're like, well, what is the y value?
And could A2 give you Skittles?
It could. I mean, I don't know. If with the crazy vending machine, anything is possible. Okay. Molly, is that a question? Or are you being weird? All right.
Oh, I didn't realize.
So, a way to figure this out graphically. Are we cool? Can I erase some things?
Yeah.
I need space.
Wait, don't worry. Erase the top. I like this diagram. I don't actually know why I did this. I don't think I'm supposed to. I drew it.
Okay, I'm erasing.
Yeah, you can erase it.
Wait, we had to.
No, you didn't have to.
Right,
I just drew it.
Vending machine
thing? I did it.
Alright, so there is a thing.
Yes.
It's called the vertical line test.
Yes.
Oh, well, yeah. I know that.
So this is a test that we can do to determine if something is a function or not. Determine if a graph is a function or not. If a vertical line drawn anywhere on the graph only passes through the curve one time, then it's a function. If you can draw a vertical line anywhere on the function where it crosses more than once, then it's not a function.
No,
so, let's say if you can draw a vertical line anywhere
or not.
On a graph that intersects twice, then it is not a function. Ooh, that's function. Wrong. So,
global warming is made up by China too.
Examples. Okay, so here are six relations. They're totally relations because there's x and y values and they're having fun. They are friends. Now, is there any place on here that we could draw a vertical line where it intersects more than once?
Yes.
Yeah.
Where?
On that one.
Oh, I just meant this guy here.
Oh.
Yeah.
So this one looks like it is a function. Yes, sir. How about this guy? Function, yes or no?
Yes.
It's a parabola.
Oh, lordy. Now this one.
Yes.
No.
Oh, it's no! I could not believe it. It crosses twice.
That's in the x.
Not a function.
That's in the x squared.
Get out of my face.
Thanks, Renee.
You're welcome, Bob.
This one.
What?
You're like
something
special. Nope.
No.
Get that out of here.
This one, check this out. I drew a line, it only crossed once.
No.
No.
Malarkey. Because I could draw a line here saying if I could draw any line, any vertical line anywhere, and if it crosses twice, meh.
But it can cross thrice.
Wrong. Nay.
So any, did I say twice? Oh, you got me. So we need to fix this to say intersects more than once?
Yeah.
Okay.
You're wrong.
Intersects twice is what I meant to say. Intersects more.
What happened was.
Than once.
Can I do greater than one? Because
autocorrect.
I love you. I mean,
roller coasters.
And how about this one?
No.
Wrong.
Fake news.
Wrong.
Fake news.
Fake news.
It is fake. It's not the whole truth, man.
Right.
Wait, so the line has to be vertical? Has to be
yes, vertical line test. We use vertical line.
Is this the horizontal line test?
That's a different thing that it's, I'm not willing to teach you at
different
this moment.
Is that
another it is a thing, and it tells you another thing about things.
Oh.
But you're not ready for such things.
Oh.